Hi, my name is Mark Piller. I'm the founder of Backendless. We're working on a cloud-based service which provides a universal backend for developers working on mobile and desktop applications. Using Backendless, developers can focus on their client side of their apps without spending any time worrying about the server-side coding. As a result, building applications with our platform is done at a fraction of the time. This is made possible by exposing core server-side functionality like data persistence, user management, or push notifications as programmable services. Each service has APIs accessible through our SDKs. We publish for all major environments, including iOS, Android, Windows Phone, JavaScript, ActionScript, and REST. Backendless is a general-purpose platform. It can be used to build any kind of application, which relies on the server-side features. There are six core services we included into our platform: user service, data service, geolocation, messaging, which also includes support for push notifications, media streaming, and file management. These services can be used individually or can be combined to build more complex applications. Backendless offers a subscription-based model and also provides a free plan so anyone can register and try it out without any cost. To see Backendless in action, we put together a few demo applications which focus on the core functions. Additionally, there is a graphical management console which can be used to customize the server-side behavior and to manage data. So let's take a look at the console and the examples. What you see on the screen is the Backendless developer console. The console is the central point for managing and working with applications. Creating a new application is very easy. Just click the Create App button, type in the application name, and you're ready to go. Once an application is created, you can manage all the aspects of this application with all the services that Backendless provides. As I mentioned, these services are users, data, media, files, messaging, and geolocation. Let's take a look at the users. The user service and the API associated with it are responsible primarily for two things. One is user registration with an application built on top of Backendless, and second is the login. However, there are a lot of different business rules around login and registration, so the screens on the console handle pretty much all of them. So as you can see, there are different settings for the login. There are also some settings for the registration. For instance, you can turn on email confirmation, so anytime a user registers, Backendless will automatically send out an email to confirm user's email address. User properties is where you can specify all the properties defining a user entity. So these are going to be the properties that you typically gather information for on the user registration form. There's also communication and email templates where for various events in the system you can configure an email, text of an email that goes out when those events occur. Security and restrictions, you can configure various security aspects. Let's take a look at the data. So data is your database in the cloud. Data is a very interesting service. You can actually work with data with Backendless without knowing anything about databases or without knowing anything about SQL. In fact, tables in the cloud could be created on the fly simply just by working with the API. To demonstrate the data service, we put together an example that uses the APIs and works with the persistent data in the cloud. It is an Android application, however, exactly the same app that works with the same data set can be implemented on top of any other SDK that we provide. So let me switch to my Android device and launch the app. So here it is. This is a to-do list, and as you can see right here on the screen, right now I have person table and users table, and there are no tables created yet which would support the to-do list. So let me create my first task, and let's call it shopping. So here it is, now we have one task, and if I were to update my screen to see if there are any tables created, now I see that there is a to-do entity table, and then here I have my task. So here's the shopping task, and the status of it is not done. Let me create another task, and let's call it workout. So there are two tasks. We see both workout and shopping. If I were to select, let's say, workout as done, and update the screen. Now see that the done column for the workout record is true. Now to demonstrate that the same data can be accessed from elsewhere, I'm going to use a plugin for Google Chrome called REST Console. And in here I can just type in the REST URL for our API and run a query. And in the response we get a JSON response, which basically both shopping and the workout records returned from our API. Now our REST API, as well as the standard APIs for all other SDKs, support queries. So the same data could actually be queried. And then here, if I were to type in where clause, so here I'm querying all the records where the column done is false. And here it is. We see that shopping is not done. So if I go back to my Android app and select shopping as done and rerun exactly the same query, no data comes back, which means that everything is synchronized. Let's go back here. In the console, it goes above and beyond of what I just showed, because it does support relational data and various tables could be related to each other. And once again, data and tables and the schemas could be created on the fly without knowing anything about databases. There is also a very strong security system where access to various operations could actually be restricted based on the roles or usernames. Let's continue our backendless tour. Next service is media. The media service is responsible for handling video or audio broadcasts right from the devices or desktops, and it also supports video recording and streaming. So anyone can just create a video chat application using our APIs without doing any programming or configuration on the server side. It is all packaged in the service. The file service handles file uploads and file sharing. Anybody can create any kind of directory structure, upload files directly from the APIs, or upload files from our console. Let me just demonstrate creating a new folder. I'm going to call this folder Documents. If I go into this folder, I can just start uploading files. So now the file is out there and it can be shared with anybody who is using the same application. A very simple service to use with a powerful API. Let's move on to the next service, which is messaging. It supports two message distribution mechanisms. One is publish-subscribe messaging, and also the second message distribution mechanism that it supports is push notifications. So with push notifications, it can distribute and deliver messages as native notifications to the Android, Windows Phone, and the iOS devices. Let me run an example and demonstrate how that works. So for messaging, I'm going to run this push notifications demo. I'm going to register my device. Now it registers with Google and then registers it with Backendless. And from here, I can just run, send a message. Let's just say this message is going to be hello. So it sends this message. And right here, we have this hello message right there on the screen. Now we also can send this message also as a push notification. So any other device that is running exactly the same application and tuned to the same channel will receive that push notification. So let's just say, this is a test push. So now notice right here at the top of the screen, when this message is delivered, it will show up as a push notification. So here I'm going to send. And as you can see right there, it actually flipped. And if we go to the notification center, we see push messages backendless sample. This is a test push right there. And if we click, it switches back to the same application. Now also, messages could actually be sent directly from our console to all the connected devices. So right here, we can just say, hi Android, and then add the headers that designate this as a push notification message and mark it as a push notification to Android and send. So here it is. We have, hey Android, push notification, urgent news. Finally, last but not least, a service that we have is geolocation. Let me switch to that screen. With geolocation, we provide a way for users to upload their geospatial data and then run queries. So here I have prepared an example where I have uploaded data about various cities across the world with their geolocation information. So here we can, if we zoom out, we can see all those markers corresponding to various data that we have in this particular database. There's also an example, so I'm going to set the radius, run search, and it makes a query to Backendless and searches for all the cities within the specified radius. Here it is, here's the result. You can just change the radius and it does the query again and comes back with data. What makes this powerful is that not only can it search within radius, but it can also search for metadata. Every single geo point that we have in the system could have metadata. And the metadata could be anything. It's just a collection of pairs, key value pairs. Let's say you want to search all the businesses that provide certain type of service. And if it is encoded as metadata, the service will return that data to you. So that concludes our demo. Hopefully it gives you an idea about Backendless. There is a lot more to it, but we wanted to keep it compact for this video. You can learn a lot more about the service at our website, backendless.com. Thanks.